The formalities are our press conference for today. We'll introduce the topic of today's press conference as well as to introduce our panelists. The spokesperson of the Bureau of Projects and the newly appointed Director for Intelligence and Investigation Service, Mr. Nicanor.
In anticipation that there will be more, and possibly some of them are currently now in transit to enter our Philippine territory. The request that our Cabinet Secretary directed the creation of an interagency task force against illicit rice traders or against rice smuggling. And we are joining us this morning, no less than Secretary, the Cabinet Secretary, Secretary Leoncio, Evasco. Palakpakan po natin ang ating presentation. Ang bago pong appointed na ating NFA Administrator, kasama rin po namin sa Air Force of the Philippines, Mr. Jason Aquino. And of course, our Commissioner of Bureau of Customs, Commissioner Nicanor, Faeldon. May we call again our Cabinet Secretary, Secretary Leoncio Evasco, for his opening statement. Sir.
My fellow government workers, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'd like to thank the Bureau of Customs, headed by Commissioner Nick Pendon. Likewise, with Mr. Jason Aquino of the National Food Authority, Attorney Hanben Valdez for organizing this press conference. And it is perhaps a public knowledge that the President has zero tolerance for rice smuggling. The President, needless to say, is also very protective of the marginalized and of our rice farmers. In order to protect the marginalized and our rice farmers, we must harmonize and synchronize efforts to ensure strict implementation of the law, particularly the Anti-Agricultural Smuggling Act of 2016, otherwise known as the Public Act 1084-5. Rice smuggling results in economic sabotage because it distorts the local price of rice. It blows the domestic supply, hence putting our citizens and rice farmers in an extremely disadvantageous situation. With that, my office, as the supervising agency of the National Food Authority, can assure the public that a more stringent accreditation process for potential companies and cooperative traders has been employed by NFA to ensure financial and governance fitness. As such, a post-qualification mechanism has been added on top of pre-qualification standards. We have also made a conscious effort to give opportunity to new but qualified players to ensure fair competition. With that, the number of qualified traders and cooperatives issued with certificate of eligibility has been doubled. This period is crucial since the arrivals of private sector-led importation have been commenced, and this is expected to last until February 28, 2017. Hence, last week, an emergency meeting among the Office of the Cabinet Secretary, NFA and Bureau of Customs was called by my office to discuss mechanism to ensure zero smuggling consistent with the President's directive. There is a need to do this since we still have unscrupulous traders who have already mastered circumventing the law and would do misdeclaration, miscalculation, misclassification, and overlanding of rice. Acts which are extremely detrimental to our impoverished citizens and rice farmers. Hence, collectively, we have agreed, first, to strictly implement the new law, which states that an import permit is needed before importation. Previously, traders are allowed to enter even if the permits are still in process. Number two, to allow only up to 2% overlanding of rice loan as allowance for potential breakage and damages. Previously, it is within the discretion of the regulatory agency. And thirdly, to amend the guidelines to remove free port zones as points of entry. Since the BOC has no jurisdiction over free port zones, therefore, could not apply customs laws. There should be an amendment to this. With that, Commissioner Nick Faeldon of the Bureau of Customs, Administrator Jason Aquino of the National Food Authority, and I, Leoncio Evasco Jr., your Cabinet Secretary, have agreed that there will be no exceptions. Violation will merit seizure of goods. We have also further agreed to study the possibility of donating all the seized rice to the Department of Social Welfare and Development for the agency's Pangtawid Pamilya Program, or for peace, and to meet the needs of disaster victims. Perhaps the government is better off with this scheme instead of auctioning the seized rice, when in reality, it is still the traders who will place the bids. Hence, we call on all the traders to heed to the President's call for zero graft and corruption, and in and out of government. We will be watching you, and we will run after you. And to my fellow government workers, please, let change emanate from your ranks. Do not allow yourselves to be used. Let us all partners with the President in his call for change. Thank you very much and good morning.
Thank you, sir. Before we start the ball rolling, we also recognize the presence of our Undersecretary Attorney by Valdez of the CAPSEC morning. Also, two of our Deputy Commissioners who are present this morning, Deputy Commissioner Natalia Carpenter, Public Bureau of Customs, Deputy Commissioner Javier Neposero, also from the Bureau of Customs. Also, our Deputy Commissioner Eddie Bufo. Deputy Commissioner Teddy Raman. Likewise, we recognize the presence of two Bureau of Customs Director James Lyon, and the newly appointed Director of our Legal Service, Director Attorney Embryo. Deputy Commissioner Jerry Campana, also here. Joining us this morning, Director Rumbala is joining us in front. And Director Mal Maestro-Pama from here. Our NP Director also want to give this message, suggestion of you.
The mission of the military is more than food security and price stabilization. So, last week, I was instructed, I was informed that any frame will report to the members of the operation. So, actually, from the members of the operation, we are close to them, but really, we also has Alcan can help the Bureau of Customs, but the lead is also the Bureau of Customs. And anyway, we only assist the Bureau of Customs for anti-terrorism.
Thank you, sir. Also joining us this morning, representing the private sector, Mr. Ernie Valdez. Sir. Okay, we will start. Questions, sir?
Likewise, the original approve imported rice and the import permit will likewise be confiscated. Third, there are ports which are recognized to be the entry of imported rice. Free port zones are not included. Unfortunately, in the past, these ports were the entry, or used to be the entry of imported smuggled rice. But there is a catch, because the law says that imported goods or rice can use the storage facilities within this free port zone. This is a very contentious provision of the law, because you can get in on the guys that you will use this as a storage of imported rice, even if it is unclear whether this imported rice is covered by import permit. Now, this is where we have to seek an amendment of the law, that free port zones should be covered and be assigned with custom officials to monitor imported rice. Kasi delikado eh, kasi kahit hindi iyan authorized as pagsaka ng bigas, but unscrupulous rice traders can use the storage facilities as an excuse of smuggling rice into our country.
Yeah. Hey, Commissioner Faeldon, the 2% overlanding of rice loads, allowance for potential wreckage and damages. Paano ba masisiguro na talagang walang kayaan sa timbangan dito? Meron na tayong ginagawang sistema dyan? Kasi focus ko dito sa mga susukan nila. Pero maganda naman ito, kasi pamimigay daw sa mga mamayang kaming kababayan sa poor peace. Ano po assurance na talagang wala na pong kayaan dyan sa 2%, down 2% ng excess? Hingan natin ang permit sa tinawalayan.
Sige, bago sa pagkini yan. I would like to support yung make a little explanation how are we going to implement yung bagong batas, yung agreement between these three agencies. You can bring your rice. Pwede nyo dalhin yung mga bigas nyo ay yung mga importers kahit sa lupalot ng Pilipinas after you have paid your duties. So do not bring your rice anywhere without paying your duties first. Because if you bring your rice anywhere without paying your duties, kukumpiskahin namin. Meaning you can obey warehouses anywhere, whether they are inside report zones or not. But that is after you pay your duties. Unlike the previous, ipipasok nyo dyan, i-hibernate dyan, then yung magkaroon ng malingat kung sino mga otoridad na nagpapantay ng mga warehouse na yan, kinalabas nito sa report. So, hindi pwede yan. Because the reason why there is map, alam niyo mo yun mga traders, that we are only importing yung hindi kayang suplayan ng locally produced rice, that's around 5%. So hindi natin pwedeng mag-angkat tayo ng 10% of the supply needed. Kasi papatayin natin yung magsasaka. That's why we'll be very strict in the implementation of the control of importation of rice. There's a question of how can we assure the public that we can control the volume of rice. Madali lang po yun. Kasi yung mga ports natin, meron po tayong mga equipment para timbangin. Meron tayong mga mascale, kung ito ay naka-containerize, kung break bulk siya, meron din tayong mga pang-timbang. In fact, that's why one of these trader na nabigyan ng bag nitong first quarter, nahuli natin. Kasi we are subjecting all your imports. We are warning you, kayong mga traders. Because one of your friend, nahuli na natin. Sinusubukan niyang palusutan yung Bureau of Customs. So tinimbang natin. At the middle of this, pagtitimbang natin, bigla siya nagpakamot. Kung nga pala, may excess pala kaming 600 metric tons. You know, that's around 1 million pesos. How could you, yung kahit na bilyonaryo yung tao, yung 5 centavos, ina-account na yan. So hindi pwedeng sabihin mo, at the middle na tinitimbang na namin, ay nakalimutan ko, meron pa palang 600 metric tons na excess yan. Yun yung i-explain ni Secretary Evasco kanina. You cannot do that now. And this person, na-seize na natin yung kanyang commodity, yung exposing the trader as soon as the investigation is completed. So to all of you traders, do not try that now because you may not succeed. So yun yung pamamaraan natin. We will weigh the rice up to the last kilo. So hindi kayo yung
Next question will be from Mr. Michael Roto of USS.
Sir.
Mr. This question is addressed to Secretary Evasco. Mr. Secretary, my name is Dr. Mike Aragon. I am the Vice President for Media Affairs of the United Filipino Consumers and Commuters, UNCC. The question is this. You mentioned earlier that about import permits, and you were saying to us that in the past, kahit na walang import permits, ginagawa yung proseso ng importation. And you told us now that pag-uwi na lahat na. Without the import permits, no, hindi pwede mo na ipapasok yung mga goods. No? We're very interested here, not only because of the issue of rice smuggling, but smuggling as a whole. Because all the importations nag-emanate dyan sa mga different agencies of government. Like for example, DDI, no? They have this import permits also based on ICC issue nila. My question is this, if this is not the policy of government, no? Applicable ba ito sa lahat ng agency ng MLS, no? Hindi lang po sa NFA, sa RICE, no? Pwede rin ba ito sa bakal, sa simento, etc. So many other importation which is based on import permits. Maraming salamat po.
Salamat, Dr. Aragon. Ganito. We are talking here of rice. How to curb, how to stop smuggling of rice, thereby disenfranchising our poor farmers producing rice. And likewise, sabotage in government by not paying the correct taxes and custom duties. I hope, Bureau of Custom will also look into this in other goods. Because there is no difference between rice importation, the importation of steel, the importation of cement, the importation of anything getting into our country should be subjected to strict compliance of the law as implemented by the Bureau of Customs, so that whoever is producing the same materials here in our country should also be protected. But I believe that to the Bureau of Customs to look into that, because I know with the leadership of Commissioner Nick Faeldon, Custom is in the right hand.
Thank you, Pop.
Next question from EBSCB.
Hi, good morning, sir. My name is Nicanor from EBSCB. Sir, can we just get one update regarding the IRR law of the Agricultural Smuggling Act?
The Bureau of Customs the one asked to prepare the IRR. This has been done 2 months ago. But we are just a bit late to the Department of Finance for the review. We are waiting for the completion of the review. Once it's done, the IRR will be published. But there's just a process done before we submitted those IRR. Consultation was done with all the stakeholders. So tapos na po yung IRR. We're just waiting for the final review of the UN. In our part, we've done it for the month ago.
Sir, can we expect stricter penalties for the IRR regarding the MTS?
Yes, the anti-proposal smuggling act was passed into law in May, so it's been effective since May. Now, for the penalty proportions, that's the reason why we come into the IRR. I spoke with the legal team of DOF Plus yesterday. They've given the promise that within the week they will complete the review. So we'll be expecting the IRR to be out for publication within the next few weeks.
Sir, update naman po sa mga smugglers po. Meron po ba tayo ng nahuli or meron po ba tayo mga minamasyad ng mga posibleng mga smugglers na pumasok?
Yes, in the past 6 months, since the President assumed office, the Bureau of Customs has confiscated at least 7 shiploads of soft rice and then 2 small boats of sugar. Wala na nga po kami bodega doon sa southern part of the country. Nilalagay na po namin sa other government offices. In fact, yung isang barko, talutang-lutang doon sa port at sa buwaga, nandun pa yung mga bigas kasi wala na tayong mapaglaro. And then the filing of cases. We are completing all the evidences so that the criminal cases to be filed against these smugglers will be filed through the DOJ, will be submitting our recommendation for criminal charges. We'll announce them. This group will let you know once these cases will be filed in court. We're just also waiting for the IRR so that this case will be airtight. We do not just want to file cases, just to file cases. We want conviction. These are our first cases to test the new law. Mind you, these are not painful cases, so we do not just want to file cases na hindi naman tama. So, sugar, rice, you will be expecting the next press conference to be called by this group who will be filing cases already for the value of course.
Sir, what are we waiting for with the confiscated rice and sugar?
As explained by Thompson, a while ago, that's how we intend to respond. In fact, that's the way we have been doing the past 6 months. It's turned over to the SWD for the calamity victims. As a country, masyadong marami yung bumibisita sa atin na calamidad. So, there is no specific amount intended for calamities, although meron tayong bond of national government. But if meron tayong bigas ready, kasi pag binagyo ka automatic, yun yung price, hindi sira yung mga panalim. So itong mga bigas na ito, malaking tulong dun sa mga kasalanan ng mga kanila.
Okay, so we have a question from Global News Network and then after that, and then
Jim. Good morning, I'm Paula Sombrero from Global News Network. My question goes to Secretary Evasco. Sir, you mentioned that this type of government will enforce a more stringent accreditation process, and this will require post-qualification mechanism. Can you, sir, elaborate more on how this mechanism will differ from the usual mechanism in terms of getting accreditation for the training course?
I think the whole process that reflects on what was done in the past. What makes it a different feature this time is that people go very, very strict. We have now the office under the cabinet secretary headed by Attorney Hanmen Bates that will see all applications for any trader to participate in buying, importing rice so that we can get the necessary documents that will prove that they are legitimate importers of rice. So it goes first to the Office of Attorney Valdez. And then from Attorney Valdez, it goes to Europe, to the National Food Authority for final check.
Sir, do we have figures on how we quantify the amount of smuggled rice probably in the past years? Yes, how do we quantify?
I think that your question is going to be asked.
Okay.
We are manually reviewing all types of smuggling done in the past 6 years. Part of the Bureau of Customs, because when I assume there's no record, electronic records, we are doing this manually in every forest. So we, because we are listing the accreditation of thousands of importers, including importers of rice and everything. So based on this review we're doing, we can now based on some nahuli natin, nahuli yung the past 6 years. But in the past 6 months, when we assume, sabi ko nga, may mga pitong barko na tayo nahuli. Nahuli natin sila. Because we are not allowing them to do their smuggling of rice. And other type of commodity. So hindi na sila nakakalusot. And then even those who have been issued marks, we are reviewing the volume of yung pinapatratin nila. Kaya nga sabi ko kanina, dineclare niya 7,200 metric tons. Yan yung pinayari niya. Eh, but because we subject all importation of rice to weighing, at the middle of the weighing, bigla niyang nalala, 7.8 pala yung kanyang ano. Nasa part niyo, yung pinaba niya. So, na-apply siya ulit ng additional 600 metric tons na import permit. So, ito yung hindi na niya aprobahan. Ito yung mga palusot nila. So, ito yung hindi na mangyayari. Dahil talaga, we'll be very strict in quantifying or in assuring that the volume declared as approved by the NFA through their mouth will be the exact rice landed to our country. In excess of that, that's really a violation. And they will be confiscated. And penalties will be imposed on them. The different scale. Ano yung kanilang pagkakamali o kanilang ginawang kikita. But the minimum is, of course, we do not regulate them, but we do not allow them. Their importation accreditation will automatically be removed from our list, so they can no longer participate, apply for vouchers or anything.
Sir,
yung
mga traders na
napatanayan na, what's smuggled and rice? Ano yung action na, what would we implement? For example, sir, yun, napatanayan na, smuggled, then, how much penalty, or can they also reapply in the future?
Immediately,
we will cease the audit. Second is, we remove them from our accreditation. And then, if it is, the rice that they try to smuggle is beyond 10 million, the fair market value, the Anti-Agriculture Smuggling Act will apply to them. In the case of this, like 2 weeks ago, 12 million yung fair market value nung kanyang sinubok na ipaluso. So when we file a case against him, when our hearing within the Bureau is done, we'll be recommending a case, economic sabotage case against this trader, that's an unbelievable case. So, mabigat yung ating bagong batas. So, I'm warning you traders, don't try the law. Kasi hindi nyo siya tatalogin.
Thank you.
TV5. So, tapos po, gano'ng marami ba yung inaalaw natin na i-import na yung bawang mga bigas kada taon ba?
Last year we had 805,000 metric tons. In this amount, in 5 acres per acre. Then for this year, we are still studying for the government development.
Pero how do we ensure na hindi naman magkulay yung set tayo ng mga agricultural products sa merkado? Dahil na rin natin medyo hindi naman pa-sustainable yung
mga bis, ano, it's a World of Internet World Trade Organization. So we, you know, we apply that for the extension of the quantitative restriction. In return, yan yung MAB. So actually, wala tayong dyan, wala tayong wala tayong control kasi requirement yan na ito ba yung hindi kang pagiging face na mga or this will be mobilized.
Pero to do is like that so monthly yung name for natin ngayon o?
Ah, no, wala mga kao this coming June this year mag-expire na yung what it will be restrictions natin.
So mas ko konti yung kulang sa tingin nyo yung name for sa atin o kailangan yung ng mga agricultural products.
Rice?
Rice or
you can have the products? Ah, yeah, we have the products. But also rice, we have still to wait for the result of the quantitative restrictions.
Sir, one of the rumors about the date, sir, hindi kaya magiging problema yun, sir, kasi alam na natin, may nahihirin pa po yan, pero diretso confiscation, information carriage, sir.
Wala po ang take the law. The news customs modernization and tariff is explicitly defined there that confiscated commodities can now be donated with the Bureau of Customs to any government agency that has a mandate for utilization or whatever process. So that's very clear in the new law. And as far as processing them is concerned, the Bureau of Customs right now under the new president's dispensation, we are doing it in just 30 days. There's no conflict in law as far as confiscated commodities are concerned. So, madali lang siya gawin. In fact, those rice we have confiscated in the past 6 months, na-dispose na po natin yan. Hindi na natin mararanasan yung pupulong na yung bigas dyan. Because we can quickly settle the issues, the legal issues.
For the knowledge of everybody, any importation of rice is a product of a deliberation by the NFA Council. Meaning to say that this is not just a knee-jerk reaction as dictated by the previous, or anybody in our country dictating the buying of rice. It is always based on the protection of our farmers, likewise, the protection of the consumers. Now, when we decide to buy rice, as I said, we look into the production of the rice farmers. The more importation of rice will always be detrimental to the rice farmers. Low or less importation of rice also would mean detrimental also to the interest of the consuming public. Now, the role of NFA is very, very important for that matter. We have to balance that buying rice would not be detrimental to the rice farmers, and at the same time, buying of rice would also be supporting to the interest of the consumers. Now, for last year, NFA Council decided to buy 500,000 metric tons of rice. That is G to G, government to government. And it is done through bidding. Meaning to say that the procurement act is always used as a guide in importing rice. Now, last year, what was bought was only 250,000 metric tons because that was the volume of rice they needed. That will protect the producers, our rice farmers, at the same time, provide rice effectively to our consuming public. So there is still 250,000 metric tons that is open for government to government, and that is still to be decided by the NFE Council. But as of now, what has been decided is to purchase rice through the mouth, minimum access volume. But we still have to regulate, as I've said, if only to protect our rice farmers and to protect also the consumers. That's it.
Yeah, next question from James. Thank you.
Yes, in the past 6 months, we have already published around 70 companies. That's representing just two ports. We have 70 collection districts or ports nationwide. So for the rest of the ports, within the week, we'll be publishing other names of companies and the key officials of those companies. So what we do in the release team, mabilis lang po yung in the past 6 months kasi we have electronic copies of these violators. So you'll be expecting every week na may mapaging publication. At the same time, we're reviewing the past 6 years to remove from our accredited importers those who have violated any custom laws or national law against smuggling. So marami po ito. We are looking at thousands of companies to be removed from our list. While we are releasing them, that's the fastest review of causes schedule is administrative only. We will also develop cases to be filed, criminal cases to be filed against those activities done by them that merits filing of criminal cases.
Sir, Lakis, is it the same? Secretary, would you want it?
Of course, individuals and including cooperatives, companies who have violated the laws of importing rice, don't expect that they should be delisted. They should be no longer allowed to participate in rice buying. Ano, they have violated na eh, bakit papakasok yung kasi na?
Mga
lumabas noon, there was a long list from the NFA as a product of the Senate investigation. So even them will be reviewed and will possibly be blacklisted. I would expect that NFA at the Bureau of Customs will review and find out who are those who should be blacklisted and no longer be allowed to participate in rice importation.
Next question from Manila Police.
We're hoping with this new effort there will be zero attempts to smuggle guns. Because talaga, non-available yung kaso eh. Now with this new law and our seriousness to implement the law, we'll stop them from attempting to smuggle guns.
Okay, next question from Mrs.
This is for Commissioner Faeldon. Sir, you mentioned before that you will back all the smugglers from the past 6 years ago. So will they also be liable to the economic sabotage criminalization, sir?
No, hindi naman. Like any other law, offenses are not retroactive. You know? It's only applicable during the time the law was enacted into it. But there are also other cases to be filed against them, not just coming somewhere else, anti-smuggling law. We already have anti-smuggling law even before the anti-agricultural smuggling act. So cases can still be filed against them.
So the next question for the NDA. Sir, you said that you're calling the nation on these excess rice imports, right? So, di po ba parang the damage yung import farmers? Kasi makapasok din siya sa market at yun yung delay. Kasi magpupunta rin sa poor families.
Kasi I think the reason was those is by the farmers. Hindi na rin ito, hindi is probably.
Pero since, sir, di ba parang may effect rin sa demand? Kasi since we have, may dinanig kayong free rice na, hindi parang less demand din sa mga bansa. Wala po ba siyang effect?
Ikaw lang, ano? Have you ever been to a place na kasalanta ng kalabidad? Magsiseros ako ba dun sa mga victims ng kalabidi na bigyan ng libre bigas? Have you experienced that? Kasi parang yun yung pinopoint out mo eh. Look naman, hindi kasalanta ng ayan eh. Bibigyan mo libre bigas, makakasama ko pa sa bansa yan.
Okay, we'll have our take last two questions. First from Port Halls, and then the other one from the PPD.
During the interagency meeting with January 4, we will have to submit this immediately to the office of the executive secretary for all these agreements to be over with the executive order to make legal any action that will emanate from this agreement.
Last question from Mr. Reformes.
No one else is in the inquiry, so I'll ask the question. I've been calling this in the inquiry. I've followed this for 12 years. This is the first time I've seen such a different approach. I'll ask this question to Mr. Faeldon. Alam mo nyo naon sa nangatay on the top, laging meron to in a cover on smuggling. Ngayon lang, nag-iit ako, ang approach na ibang iba, tatanggap ko ito sa inyo. It is on record, the current police pardon has increased the catching of people for the execution to congratulate them. But today we see something else, it is not catching, it is preventing. And Secretary Evasco, instead of catching more people, has stopped them from even trying. The IPs, instead of catching those, they cannot even enter. Diba? Pupunta na ko sa inyo. Ang tanong ko po, yung good work na ginawa niyo, si NFA, preventing is done for rice. Then ang po niya, are you going to do for other agricultural products? But that's not the only precedent that Pupunta na ko sa inyo. Another precedent he did, It's no more auction because the people buy it anyway. The traders and others are punishing those who change pinapalit nila. Pagdating nila, papalitan those people. Under General Pascal's model and you, they cannot change. Today, there's still auctioning, there's change and all that. Will you consider, same as your question, no? Yung IP, gawin mo rin yun sa mga produkto. Pero hindi na ang IP nangyari ng araw na ito. Ngayon araw na ito, pinagbawalan yung changing after arrival, pinagbawalan yung auctioning to the smugglers themselves. Commissioner Faeldon, congratulations on your great work. Will you now add to your excellent chasing of smugglers the preventive actions that is a precedent I've never seen in 12 years to other products, sir? You will do consider it for other products so that they also have no more auction, no more IP usage, and no more negotiating after the arrives. Will you consider that, Commissioner Faeldon?
Yes, sir. We are looking for, in fact, one of the long, medium-term plans of the Bureau of Customs is to build our own rendering facilities here. Because this is where the possible future ideas of these commodities, when we auction them for rendering services. Let's talk about steel products. When DTI Bureau of Standards classified them as substandard, the government has to pay 32 pesos for every piece of steel product para putol-putulin yan, para hindi na siya magamit sa construction. Minsan, ito ay nung in the past, not under my watch, because we have a CCNC. Ito na aking pass, na-auction, hindi pinuputol, ibinibenta as a whole. So to completely remove this practice is to come up with the law rendering facilities. Meat. Let's talk about meat. Processed shell. So instead of sinisira ito, napupunta sa market. So if you have our own rendering facilities here, talaga masisira yan. Hindi siya mapupunta sa market. And so other, and the rest of the other products. Those can still be used for public consumption, cannot be also donated to other government agencies for their distribution to the public. So we have to classify commodities that's allowed by law na gagamitin. That's not allowed by law na gagamitin. So it's just classifying it. But first we have to come up with our own rendering facilities. So that, kasi kung ipagin natin yan lahat po dyan, sir, ay wala tayong paglalagyan. Unlike for a where we can deliver it, rice, where we can deliver it to the warehouses of NFA for storage purposes. Other commodities, wala po tayong government established warehouses for them. So we need our rendering facilities too. But that's the medium-term project of the Bureau of Customs. And of course, we have to discuss this with regulatory offices concerned per product. We have 54 regulatory agencies scattered all over the different offices of the highway.
Salamat.
Okay, so thank you to the members of media for your questions. To our panelists, Commissioner Faeldon, Secretary Pascal, and Mr. Aquino, do you have any closing statements?
By the way, for your information, the President issued the first executive order clarifying the task of the Office of the Cabinet Secretary vis-a-vis the Office of the Executive Secretary and Office of the Special Assistant to the President. At the same executive order, some agencies, I think regional agencies, put under the Office of the Cabinet Secretary. One of these joint agencies is NFA. That's why I'm here this morning. And for my last word, to no single attempt to smuggle rice. Please stop. Not because you're afraid to be caught, but please respect this government is trying to do good and to do right in responding to the needs of our people. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone who attended our press conference. Thank you, and